Hello everyone, today we'll see about demand analysis and types of demand. What is this demand? This is a very important concept in managerial economics. Demand means where there is a willingness and a capacity to buy a particular product by the consumers, we can say there is a demand. Without demand, we cannot run the business. Without demand, we cannot go forward for the business work. So that is why demand is very much required. If demand is there, automatically you will have more production. If you have more production, sales will be more. Sales are more means profit. Everything is interlinked. So that is why demand is very much required. And to understand a demand concept, if you have a knowledge of demand concept, then you can go ahead for decision making and to take up any kind of decisions and to understand and to make any kind of strategies for planning and all those things based on the knowledge of demand only. Now what is demand? A small definition I will tell you. So demand means the desire of any product or service, desire of any product or service that a person wishes to buy at a given price. A person who is willing to buy product or service at a given price is nothing but a demand. Suppose say person A is willing to buy the product but no capacity, there is no demand. Where willingness plus capacity to buy the product, then we can say it as a demand is there for that product. So we'll see now today types of demand. How many types of demand are there? 8 types of demands are there. So the first demand is individual and market demand. Individual demand means only one consumer is willing to buy a particular product, that is individual demand. And rather than that, market demand. Market demand is entire market. How many people? Many people are willing to buy the product. Say Sony company products are there, Sony Electronics. TV, phone, telephone and smart computers, all these things. So many people are willing to buy a lot of products, then that is market demand. Individual demand is only one person. Or you can say it as a demand for one apple, demand for one computer, demand for one guitar. So all these things, one product. For market, total market, how much demand is there for computers? How much demand is there for ACs? This is market demand altogether. So second one is that demand for firms' products and industries' products. Only for firms and for industries. Firm means only one organization, one company, one firm. How much demand is there for ABC company? Or how much demand is there for Procter & Gamble company? Or Hindustan Lever Limited company? Only that company, how much demand is there for their products is, we call it as a firm's products. And industry's products. Industry's products. How much demand is for the total entire industry? Say for example, if you take steel. Steel. Only steel demand in particular area, in particular company only. ABC company, steel limited company is there. How much demand is there? So that is firm's demand. Total steel industries, total companies of all the country. So that is industry. Industry demand, steel demand for all the industries of the country. Then that is industry demand. The same third one, autonomous and derived demand. Autonomous demand is simply which is not depending on anything. Simple example, you can take autonomous demand, consumer products and buying any food items, groceries and steel items or any electronic items. All these things are we can say it is autonomous normal demand we have. And derived demand, because of one demand, there is another demand, that is derived demand. Suppose say best example which you can take, there is a venture, plots are selling. When plots are selling, all are going under the construction. They are going for the independent houses or any kind of firms constructions they are doing. When plots are selling, it is normal demand. And when construction is going, derived demand is cement and steel and any other products like the other things like paints and whatever is required for the construction like rate and all these things which comes under the derived demand. because of one demand, other demands are there. Derived demand is one another example which you can take. Near to the school, there is a stationery shop, there is a Xerox center, so there is a small tiffin center. All these things are derived demand because of school demand. Near to the hospital, medical shop, derived demand. So like you can take it as a derived demand and autonomous demand. And fourth one is demand for durable, non-durable goods. Durable goods, take any fixed assets like furniture, a refrigerator, or TV, and buildings, machinery, all these are durable demand. And another side, non-durable demand. Non-durable demand means perishable goods you can take. Daily we take food items like groceries, like milk products, vegetables, fruits, all these things are perishable, not durable. So these types are, we call it as a non-durable goods, a non-durable demand. Next one, short-term and long-term demand. Short-term demand is only for temporary period, long-term demand is for ever, for long period. Short-term demand which you can take generally seasonable items like season, according to season. Rainy season, there will be demand for the umbrellas, raincoats, and in winter you'll find a demand for the sweaters, shawls, and in summer there are demand for only for air coolers, ACs, ice creams, cool drinks, etc. So all these things are short term demand, only for temporary period, season wise. Long term demand, for long period there is a demand. In short term period demand, you can take even the fashion also. Fashionable items like garments, only temporary. When the fashion changes, automatically it changes. Now long term demand is not like that. Forever you will find that demand. The best example, food items like rice, oil, any grocery items. Forever you need it. It's a long term demand. And some other demands like purchasing house, machinery, furniture, and whatever is needed in our regular life, which is must, compulsory. So long-term demand. Always you'll find demand. And another one is joint demand and composite demand. Joint demand is sometimes because of one product, there will be another product's demand will be there. Say for example, my product is computer. So computer related, all the joint parts I want. So when I have to go for manufacturing of computer, I need mouse and other compact items like CPU, mouse, and other inside of the part items, everything is needed. So that kind of transaction, that kind of demand, we say it as joint demand. For one product, we are buying some other material which is required is joint demand. Composite demand. Composite demand means there are several alternative uses for such kind of demand. Say for example, if you take steel, there are different uses of steel. Or if you take garments, if you take a simple cloth, we can do a lot of things. So like wherever there is a several transactions, several items which are possible, so then we call it as a composite demand. Next one is direct and indirect demand. Directly for a particular product you want to buy, that's direct. Indirect demand, there is a demand for scooter, there is a demand for car, automatically there will be demand for petrol also, there will be demand for services also. So like we say it as indirect demand, though directly it is not, but indirectly it is linked, it is connected. The last one is total market and segment market demand. Total market demand, so total market demand is for one particular product, for one particular services, there is a demand for total. Say you can take education services, entire country is needed, so that's total market demand. Segment market demand, only in particular area there is a demand. Say for example, only Mumbai or any other place, Calcutta or otherwise Chennai, only in that particular area what is the demand of that particular product or service, that we say it as a segment market demand. So if we have an understanding about types of demand, and whenever you start a business, then you will get a knowledge that what is this demand, that demand, and according to that you can go for forecasting of planning and marketing decisions, pricing decisions, everything is possible if we have knowledge of all these demands. So how many discussed? We have discussed 8 types of demand. What is demand? Where there is a willingness and a capacity to buy the product by a customer, by a consumer, that's called as demand. Okay, in demand we have discussed total 8 types of demand. So those are individual market demand, demand firms and demand for industries, autonomous and derived demand, demand for durable and non-durable, short term and long term demand, joint demand, composite demand, direct and indirect, total market and segment market demand. So these are the demands. In further, I'm going to talk different types of demand and how we can go for the demand decisions and elasticity of demand. Lot of concepts are there. So keep in touch with me. Do share these videos with everyone. Stay blessed. Practice well. Good luck.